Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. It's Emmanuel here, and in today's video I want to show you how you can create retargeting ads. And if you run ads, this is very important because it helps you increase your conversion rate, right? So if you run ads to a cold audience and you have, let's say, 10% conversion rate, if you run that same ad to a warm or hot audience, you will likely get 50-60-70% conversion rate, right? So that's what I'll show you how to do here. I'll show you how you can run retargeting ads on Facebook. And this is very important because anytime you try to sell a product, you are selling to any of these three categories of people, right? You're either selling to a cold audience. Now this cold audience are people who have never heard about you before. They don't know who you are, they don't know what you are up to, they don't understand what you are trying to do, right? So they are just seeing you for the first time, they are just hearing your name for the first time, right? And most advertising on Facebook are targeted at these people in the cold audience category. Then you also have people in the warm audience category. These are people who have come in contact with your brand, with your business, with your name, with your product in one way or the other, right? So these people are aware of what you do, but they are not really connected. They have not made a commitment to your brand yet. They have not made a commitment to your business, but they know you are, right? And they know what you have to offer. Then you have people in the hot audience category. Now, people in this class, they know you very well, they understand you very well. They have bought a couple of your products, and if you create more products, they'll still buy from you again. So these people are more like loyal customers, right? They have built a relationship with your brand and they'll follow you wherever you go, right? So most advertising on Facebook are targeted at the cold category of people. But if you start targeting people in the warm audience category, people in the hot audience category, you are going to get more conversions because these people, they know you, they like you, and they trust you. So when you start running ads to cold traffic, you want to, with time, start targeting your warm and your hot audience, right? And retargeting ads help you achieve that. You are able to reach people who have engaged with your business before. You're able to reach people who know your business. You're able to reach people who have bought your product before. That's what retargeting ads can help you do. And this is very important, most especially if you are selling different products. So once somebody buys one product from you, chances are they'll buy from you again. So you want to show them the other products you've got, the other offers you've got. And that's where you use retargeting ads. And sometimes, a lot of people don't buy at first sight, right? So they'll have to see your ad over and over again for them to buy from you. So for you to reach them over and over with your product, with your campaign, you use retargeting ads as well, right? And also, there are steps, there are processes you like to take your audience through, right? So probably somebody clicked on a sign up on your website for a free product. You want to retarget them with another offer and all of those stuff. So retargeting ads help you achieve all these things that I've just mentioned. And in this video, I'll show you how you can set up retargeting ads, right? But before we get started, I just want you guys to like this video, click the thumbs up button below. That will really help spread this video, right? And if this is your first time of visiting this channel, you're welcome. On this channel, what I do is to create videos that will help you build and grow your online business. So if you are looking for a way to start making money online, you are making money online, you are looking for a way to grow, this channel is one channel you want to stick to, right? So make sure you subscribe to the channel and make sure you turn on notifications so that anytime I upload videos like this, you get notified by YouTube, right? So with that said, let's get started. Now here I am inside Ads Manager, and for you to create retargeting ads, you need to create a custom audience of your warm audience, right? Of your warm traffic. You need to create a custom audience of people who have in one way or the other engaged with your business, right? So to do that, First, you come to this two section here and you click on audiences. All right, once you are here, the next thing you need to do is to create audience, right? Then you click create custom audience. Now at this point you select the type of custom audience you want to create, right? You want to create a custom audience of people who took an action on your website, who took an action on your app. You want to create a custom audience of your customer list, people who have bought from you before and you have their emails, phone numbers and names. You can do that. You want to create a custom audience of people who took an offline activity, right? And if it's an activity on Facebook, probably people watched your video, liked your page, engaged with your post and all those stuff, you can create a custom audience of them here, right? So for instance, if I want to create a custom audience of people who have bought my product before, I'll select people my website, because that's where the purchase happened, right? So but if you want to create a custom audience of people who have seen your page before, you select page and you set that up. If you want to create a custom audience of people who have engaged with your Instagram page before, select Instagram account and you set that up, right? So let me click website and then I'm going to click next. Now, so at this point, what you want to do is to select the pixel you want to use. So let's say this is the pixel I want to use. And then the event I want to create a custom audience of, I can just come down here and use purchase, right? Now, Facebook will help me gather the data of people who have bought my product before, right? Then you want to select how long you want these people to be in this your audience group, right? So let's say I want them to be in this group for 180 days, which is the maximum for website activities, right? Then you want to name your audience. So let me just name my audience. I can just name them buyers, right? People have bought from me. You can add description if you want. Then you click on create audience. Now, one thing a custom audience help you do is that you can create a lookalike of these people, right? And what this means is people who have bought from you before, you tell Facebook to help you look for people who look closely like them. And that will also help you increase your conversion rate when you are trying to sell with ads. Because if you create a lookalike of people who have bought from you before, that means your ads will be reaching people who have the same interests, the same behavior, the same demographics that are most likely to buy from you, right? So you can start to create a lookalike audience. So let's say I've created a custom audience of people who bought from me. And as you can see, Facebook is still gathering data of these people. I can just select this audience here and then select this and then create lookalike. Now I can select the location I want my lookalikes to come from. So let's say I want Facebook to gather a lookalike audience of people who have bought from me that are in Ghana, right? So I select the country Ghana. Now you can choose the percentage lookalike you want. Now, the lesser the percentage, the more closely related the people that will be categorized into this audience list will be to your custom audience, right? So that's why most times it's good you leave it at 1% lookalike. So the most closely look like your custom audience. Then once you've done that, you want to click on create audience. All right. So at this point, as you can see, this is a custom audience of people bought from me, still gathering data. Custom audience, lookalike audience of people who bought from me, still gathering, right? So at this point, once you've created the custom audience of the audience category you want, people who like your page, people who engage with an ad, you can create a custom audience of all those categories of people. Then the next thing you want to do is to go back to Ads Manager. Alright, so here on Ads Manager, I'll create a new campaign. And basically what I'm going to do is to target my custom audience, right? So let's say I want to create a traffic campaign. I'll click continue. Alright, so I'll click next, or maybe I could give my campaign a name if I want, then click next. Alright, so at the ad set level, select your budget, select where you are driving traffic to, then select your start date and end date if you want. Then under audiences, I'll just look for my custom audience. So I'll just select buyers. So with this, any ad I will run with this targeting will be directed at people who have bought from my website before, right? So I'll select this, and these guys are more likely to buy more of my product. That's if you really delivered value on the first product they bought from you. Then select your age and do all the normal stuff you need to do. Set up your ad, the post or the ad you want to use, and then you click publish, and that's all. This way all the ads I'll be running will be directed at my hot audience. People have bought from me before, they have tested what I have to offer, and they know that I can deliver, right? So whatever I'm selling here will likely give me more sales and more money, because usually retargeting ads will sell upsell ads, actually sell higher level of your product, right? So this is how you create retargeting ads to help increase your conversion rates on Facebook. Most times retargeting ads actually brings you better results at a cheaper rate, right? So if you are running an ad to a cold traffic and you're also running an ad to a warm traffic, the cost per result will be far lower with the warm traffic than with the cold traffic, right? And that's because it's actually easy for your warm audience to buy from you. And also, most times the message you direct at your cold traffic is different from the message you direct at your warm traffic, right? So basically, that's just how it works. I hope this helps you, and I hope this helps you grow your marketing and your business. So thanks for watching, and before you go, make sure you give this video a like, and also if you are not yet subscribed, you don't want to miss the next video that will come on this channel, make sure you subscribe right now and turn on notification, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.